Hello, and welcome to my review of Titan's Return Legends Class Wheelie. So as you can see, this toy is predominantly two shades of orange with some silver highlights. It's got transparent smoky black on the window and the wheels, and it's also got red highlights on the tail light. Look, overall it's a pretty neat feature, and I'll tell you what, it's not every day that fans actually get excited over a Generation 1 wheelie. Just to give a bit of context here, and especially for any of our younger viewers who may not have been around for this, this is the original Generation 1 wheelie toy. That's actually, this is the original, this is a reissue. Okay, this was released in 1986 as part of the Autobot mini cars. And in my opinion, this is by far the worst of all the mini cars, because you're comparing this with toys like Bumblebee, Cliffjumper, Gear, and I'm only talking about toys, right? Compared to any of those other mini cars, this is by far the weakest. And as I said, we're comparing this toys with the likes of Bumblebee, Cliffjumper, and Hubcap, and you know, Outback, and so forth. By the standards of the day, this was just crap. All right. And then we get into the character in the Generation 1 cartoon, which the best way for me to describe it is that Wheelie is to Transformers Generation 1 what Jar Jar Binks is to Star Wars. That says it all. So anyway, it's not every day that we get excited over a Generation 1 Wheelie for anything, but this is a pretty cool toy. When I first saw the pictures, I actually got excited. Okay, and this is actually based on Wheelie from the IDW comics, whose character is based more on the original Wheelie's toys textbook's bio, which describes him as a survivalist. He's like the wild boy from the jungles. He's not meant to be this usual camp character that we saw in the cartoon. He's, you know, utterly useless. There is a book from the 80s called Wheelie, Wild Boy of Quintessa, which really accurately shows what Wheelie is supposed to be. He's more like Mowgli from the Jungle Book, not Jar Jar Binks. That's what this character represents, so that already makes it cool in my books. Okay, so aside from the usual roll forward and backwards, another cool feature of this toy is that it actually has a cockpit, okay, which is designed to hold a pilot. According to the instructions, this is supposed to hold a Titan Master, which I don't have any. And as far as I know, they haven't been released yet. But eventually, when they come out, it should fit in here. Okay, so I tried to fit various other Transformer pilot-like figures into this cockpit. So I won't repeat the attempts, but just to show you for the sake of size comparison, this is a 1987 Headmaster Nibelin, Spike from Fortress Maximus. There's no way he's fitting in there. Arcana from Generations Brainstorm, even though he's a bit skinnier than the Generation 1 version, it still doesn't really fit because the feet just won't go in there. Alright, so that doesn't work. This is Quig, who's a Headmaster Nibelin from the 1988 Headmasters, or Headmaster Juniors as they were called in Japan. Surprisingly, also too big, just won't fit. Alright, so none of the previous Headmaster components will fit, either from Generation 1 or even Generations. Okay, now, the only one I could make fit is a toy that's not even really a Transformer. This is a pilot from Diaclone, or Diacron in Japanese. Many of you will know that this is the forerunner line to Transformers. Okay, many of the original Generation 1 Transformers actually had little pilots like this inside, but when Hasbro released it for Transformers, they didn't include the pilots, since Transformers are meant to be living robots. But if you ever wondered why toys like the Decepticon Jets, Autobot Cars, and Optimus Prime all have pilot compartments, that's why. They originally had pilots. Okay, now this figure actually does fit. Although the cockpit is too big,
And there's a good chance that the figure will fall backwards inside. Yeah, you still see here he's lodged to the side. There you go, he just falls backwards. Based on Wheelie's cockpit size, I'm going to estimate the size of a Titan Master to be somewhere between the size of these two guys. Don't worry, I'm sure someone else will post a review with a Titan Master in it after it comes out. Anyway, so that's a pretty neat feature for a small Legends class figure to actually be able to hold a pilot is in itself quite nice. Now,
the main thing that bugs a lot of people, also is the main drawback with having a pilot's compartment, is that the pilot's compartment typically becomes this immovable block which you have to work around. Okay, all the Generation 1 figures that have it, you know, it was this solid core, same with the Headmasters, and even Generations Brainstorm, with the, you know, his chest is a solid core, you can't do much with it, but that's okay because they're all fairly large figures, so you didn't really notice it that much. Okay, but on a small Legends class figure, if you're going to leave this as a solid block, the toy would otherwise suffer. So the transformation they've done with this is actually fairly interesting, and I would go as far to say that relative to size and price point, it has the flavor of Masterpiece in it, and that's really cool. Because one thing that Masterpiece is really good at is, making really good use of space. And we see these in toys like Masterpiece Bumblebee and Ironhide, and no doubt Ratchet, which I haven't received yet, but I know some of you have that toy. But, you know, they're really good at economizing space, and Wheelie does just that. And that's a really nice thing to see in what is a relatively small and cheap mass retail toy and not an adult collectible toy like the Masterpiece. All right, so we're just going to take these wheels down here. Okay, put that out. I don't need to narrate this, you people have eyes. Well, if you don't, you're probably not going to enjoy this video very well. All right, so yep, forgot the knees, that all's going down here. Turn the waist. Now, here's the clever part here. Actually, before I get to that, I'll flip the head out. Okay. So, we lift up this chest, and essentially, you see here, this collapses in on itself. So, this is the economization of space, right? Then this comes in here. So, all that cockpit space has now been reduced, okay, to create the core of the robot's torso, the core of the body. That's amazing, all right? So the tabs lock in here, and we swivel these here to form their forearms. And here we have Wheelie. There you go. 9 points of articulation, again, most of which are on ball joints. The head has a faux windscreen visor. Okay, it's actually not the windscreen from the vehicle mode as you have with the Generation 1 figure. And that's really cool because it allows it, you know, to have that sort of nice looking head without the oversized brim over it. It separates the dark and lighter orange colors fairly well. Okay, so does the Generation 1 toy, but unlike the Generation 1 toy, it actually breaks up a lot of the orange with a lot more other colors like the silvers and the white. Okay, so a lot more white visible through thighs, forearms, and also around the shoulders. And of course, we have a silver face with blue eyes. Okay, so that's pretty cool. So there's a lot more happening color-wise. For those of you who still think that this is a little bit too bland, you might want to wait for the Japanese version, as judging from images, they've given that one gray legs or silver legs, but it's got even more colors happening in that version. Okay, but look, I'm overall still pretty happy with the Hasbro one. I think that this is still a really fine figure. I think it's got a lot of positive things going for it. You know, I really like the way it's sculpted, the way it poses and everything. It's just fantastic.
The design of using the ball joints here really reminds me of of Beast Wars, a lot of the basic figures that we had, like Rat Trap and whatnot, which gave us really excellent poseability and articulation through that use of ball joints, and it's nice to see that making somewhat of a comeback here. The hands here are sculpted to hold any 5mm post weapon, which I'll just demonstrate now with Rewind's gun, not included with this toy, of course. Okay, which you can hold like this. And there are actually figures going back all the way from Generation 1, which have 5mm posts, including the original Optimus Prime, the original Soundwave, all the cassettes, and so on. So the 5mm post gimmick has been around since Transformers started, and it's good to see them continuing to standardize that. Okay, so that's awesome. My only real criticism of this toy is that he doesn't have a weapon of his own. The card art shows him holding a slingshot. It would be nice if he came with a slingshot. It doesn't have to be a slingshot. I'd be happy with a handgun, whatever. It just seemed like a bit of a wasted opportunity, not giving him any kind of weapon. So that's a bit unfortunate, but overall not a deal breaker. Overall, I think he's a great toy. Well worth the money. If you want a different color scheme, have a look at the pictures of the Takara Tomy version online, and you can decide whether you want to get the Hasbro version or the Japanese version. But either way, it's a very solid mold, a very fun mold. The transformation is intuitive. I love the gimmick, that being able to hold a pilot, but at the same time, the way that that cavity is compacted into robot mode is incredibly clever, and I think a very nice feat of engineering, and it doesn't at all detract from the toy. And as I mentioned in my Rewind review, I think a good gimmick on a toy is one that doesn't compromise or interfere with the toy, and this is exactly the case with this cockpit feature. Even if you think this is silly, that's fine. You can happily ignore this gimmick and just never use it. Okay, just as you did with the Generation 1 Autobot cars. We grew up with these toys without these little pilots, and we didn't care. Okay, it was a redundant feature and we didn't bother using it. These toys are still just as enjoyable without the pilots, and the same goes for a wheelie, whether you choose to give them a pilot or not. It doesn't really detract from the core value of this toy. So overall, I do highly recommend this toy. Thanks for watching.